Good day, students. I am Dr. Rachna Mathur, and BA Part 2 students, we are revising the poetry by Alfred Tennyson. The name of the poem is Tears, Idle Tears. Tears, Idle Tears is a lyric poem written in 1847 by Alfred Lord Tennyson, 1809 to 1892. So life of Alfred Lord Tennyson is from 1809 to 1892. The Victorian era English poet. So he is considered as the Victorian era English poet, published as one of the songs in The Princess, 1847. It is regarded for the quality of its lyrics. A Tennyson anthology describes the poem as one of the most Virgilian of Tennyson's poems and perhaps his most famous lyric. Readers often overlook the poem's blank verse. The poem does not rhyme. I am reading the poem for you. Tears, idle tears, I know not what they mean. Tears from the depth of some divine despair rise in the heart and gather to the eyes in looking on the happy autumn fields and thinking of the days that are no more. Fresh as the first beam glittering on a sail that brings our friends up from the underworld, sad as the last which reddens over one that sinks with all we love below the verge, so sad, so fresh the days that are no more. Ah, sad and strange as in dark summer dawns the earliest pipe of half awakened birds to dying ears, when unto dying eyes the casement slowly grows a glimmering square. So sad, so strange the days that are no more. Dear as remembered kisses after death, and sweet as those by hopeless fancy feigned on lips that are for others, deep as love, deep as first love, and wild with all regret. Oh, death in life, the days that are no more. So now we will analyze this poem. Tennyson was inspired to write Tears, Idle Tears upon a visit to Tintern Abbey in Monmouthshire, an abbey that was abandoned in 1536. He said the convent was, quote, full for me of its bygone memories, unquote, and that the poem was about the passion of the past, the abiding in the transient. William Wordsworth also wrote a poem inspired by this location in 1798, Tintern Abbey, which develops a similar theme. While Tintern Abbey may have prompted the poem, it seems unlikely that its powerful emotion derived only from a generalized feeling for the past. The final stanza in particular strongly suggests Tennyson's unhappy attachment to the lovely Rosa Baring, whose wealthy family lived in Harrington Hall, a short distance from Tennyson's Somersby. Rosa's family evidently disapproved of Rosa's continued relationship with the son of Somersby's alcoholic clergyman, and she ultimately severed the connection. The kisses by hopeless fancy faint on lips that are for others, and the cri de coeur deep as first love and wild with all regret seem to have little to do with Tintern Abbey and much to do with a personal disappointment in love. Tears, Idle Tears is noted for its lyric richness and for its tones of paradox and ambiguity, especially as Tennyson did not often bring his doubts into the grammar and symbolism of his work. The ambiguity occurs in the contrasting description of the tears. They are quote-unquote idle, yet come from deep within the narrator. The quote, happy autumn fields, unquote, inspires sadness. Literary critic Cleanth Brooke writes, when the poet is able, as in Tears, Idle Tears, to analyze his experience, and in the full light of the display and even apparent contradiction of the various elements, bring them into a new unity, he secures not only richness and depth but dramatic power as well. So I'm repeating, Tears, Idle Tears is noted for its lyric richness and for its tones of paradox and ambiguity, especially as Tennyson did not often bring his doubts into the grammar and symbolism of his works. The ambiguity occurs in the contrasting description of the tears. They are quote-unquote idle, yet come from deep within the narrator. The quote, happy autumn fields, unquote, inspires sadness. So, happy autumn fields, they inspire sadness. Literary critic Cleanth Brooke writes, when the poet is able, as in Tears, Idle Tears, to analyze his experience and in the full light of the disparity and even apparent contradiction of the various elements, bring them into a new unity, he secures not only richness and depth but dramatic power as well. So students, try to write the critical analysis of the poem in your own words. Thank you, students.